My research tells me that sometimes doors can't be opened by the traditional methods, like maybe they're locked, or they're stuck, or there's 1,000 pounds of beanbags on the other side, and you have to open the door, you have to force it open. You know who's good at forcing open doors? Firefighters like Mike. Mike and I met at a New York City firefighter training facility to go over all the firefighter techniques for opening doors that don't want to open. He was talking about, like, how to save people, and I said, I just want to open doors. Now, Mike, one thing that you did was you invented an incredible door.
It's a forcible entry prop. It mimics how a door feels when you force it, but you don't have to keep replacing the door.
If you could learn about door opening techniques from a guy who literally invented a door, would you do it? Yeah, I would too. So we're two buddies. We're best friends.
Best friends.
We're firefighting buddies and we're partners. They call us for the worst fires because we can open any door.
Any doors.
It's Big Mike
Hopefully.
And Big Dave, right?
Hopefully, yeah.
Mike, we got the call.
Okay.
We got to handle our business.
I'm going to show you first the techniques with this.
And what is this called?
It's a Halligan tool.
The Halligan tool can be used to open doors in a lot of different ways. Mike showed us one way, and that was more than enough.
I'm dropping this in between door stop and door, okay? And I'm going to be coming down. It's all what? Leverage. That's all it is. All right? We call it gapping move. It does three things at one time. It'll actually put a real hurting on the immediate locks in that area. Actually,
that was very tough thing that you just said.
Yeah,
it's going to put a hurting on the immediate locks in
exactly.
that area.
Exactly.
So that's the first thing it
and
does.
And the second thing is we're going to be able to see what other locks would be engaged.
So visually, you're learning about the door
as you do
based on that initial opening.
Exactly. That's the second thing that gapping does.
Okay.
The third thing is if I couldn't clear it, I can just rotate this, okay?
Yep.
And push down. And get the door to there, and then we'll pop it open.
With each successive motion, you are trying to gain more and more leverage.
Exactly.
Right?
That's all this is.
Okay.
And once it pops with the tool, you can control it. Pull the door back.
Now so you are in charge of the door.
Now we can get ready and go in like gentlemen.
Okay. Well, entering like a gentleman is very important to me.
Yes.
And I don't care if the building is on fire or if lasers are shooting at me. I want to act like a gentleman. When forcing open a door, use steadily increasing amounts of leverage.
Push to the door. Here you go.
Ready?
The end of the tool, right? One, two, three.
Ow!
Ooh, you got your finger? Oh,
look what he just did to me! This is a huge expose about
this. This is why you gotta wear gloves.
So basically what we've learned today is don't come within 50 miles of a door unless you're wearing some heavy-duty gloves.
Gloves.
You see what I'm saying? As much as I like having blood spurt everywhere and being the center of attention, sometimes I just want to enter a locked door without doing damage to my body.